At Last by Bram Stoker. Audiobook 1x1. At Last When I Was Young. I'm not very old yet, but I was very young then, and it all seems long ago. I made an ass of myself. It wasn't very bad, not criminal, but I was pretty well ashamed of it, for my people were of high rank and held a great position in the county. When I came back, I was afraid to tell the girl I was engaged to. She was a clever girl, and she knew by a sort of instinct that there was something, and asked me what it was. I denied that there was anything. That did for me, for I knew she was clean grit, and that she would have the truth or nothing, and as I didn't want to tell her I was a liar as well as an ass, I shoved for Australia. What I did there doesn't concern you much, and it was pretty tame, anyhow. I only mention this that you may understand something later. I had been a medical student, and liked the work so well that I have had a sneaking fondness for everything connected with it ever since. On the ship I went out on was a nurse, who was going out as an assistant matron to one of the Melbourne hospitals. She was a young woman, but with white hair, and she used to come down to the steerage where I was, and try to be of service. I had become a kind of volunteer help to the doctor, who recognized that I had been a gentleman. You are not much of a gentleman in a steerage, I can tell you, and made things a little comfortable for me in several ways. By being about with him I met the nurse, and we became very good friends. She was very sympathetic, and knew pretty well that I was sore-hearted about something, and with the natural sweet helpfulness of a woman, God bless him, soon got to know my secret. One night, I shall never forget it, a heavy, still night with the moon a blaze of gold over the silent sea. We sat out late, right over the screw, which ground away beneath us but disturbed us no more than the ticking of a clock. The mystery of the place, and the hunger for sympathy which always gnawed at my soul, got the better of me, and I opened my heart as I have never done before or since. When I stopped I saw that her great eyes were gleaming out over the sea, and the tears were rolling down her cheeks. She turned to me and took my hand between both of hers and said, "Oh, why didn't you tell her all? She would have forgiven all, everything, and would have loved you better for it all your life long. It is the concealment that hurts. Noble natures feel it most. I know,